here and good to be here to celebrate the work that we have been able to do together. Thank you, Faith, for that kind introduction and your leadership, both at this Center for Excellence in Homeownership Education as well as the Orange County Rural Development Advisory Corporation. We have quite a few people here who have been critical to our efforts to help homeowners and to really dig even deeper than that, that we are together moving the housing market in New York, and we will continue to do so together in the years ahead. I'm very proud of the fact that my office is co-sponsoring this conference and grateful to the entire CXHE team for organizing the event. But I really don't want to go any further without thanking the incredibly hardworking, dedicated, and effective housing counselors and legal service providers from your member organizations across the state who really are the ones that have made our Homeowner Protection Program such a success over the last 2 years. And we deal a lot these days in government, especially with the collapse of a lot of programs that should be and would have been taken care of by the federal government in other times. We deal with a lot of problems that seem to be beyond solution. It's a very gratifying to be here with you to celebrate tremendous success and to be able to anticipate further success as we help homeowners, we help families, we help communities all across the state that were devastated by the collapse of the housing market. And I have to say that the most challenging and difficult work that I've done since becoming Attorney General probably has been in this area, but it certainly has been worthwhile, and I thank all of you for making it so. I also want to recognize our anchor partners who have really worked with us to set up the HOPP network, the Center for New York City Neighborhoods, led by Christy Peel, and the Empire Justice Center, led by Kirsten Keefe. We would not have a program. My staff also, Dina Levy, Mike Mead, and others who are here. Dina spoke at a program earlier, architecture. So let me speak a little bit about the fact that we have a lot of different points of data that we can refer to now, because as I'm going to explain, we approached the collapse of the housing market and the way to deal with the banks and accountability different than any other state, and we've had more success because of that. But it's important to reflect on the fact that this is not just a matter of numbers, and there is no way to create metrics to measure the peace of mind of families that are afraid of losing their home and then learn that they can continue to live in it. The disruption, loss of jobs, displacement of children from schools, this is something that creates fear in the hearts of lots and lots of people in our state, and for them to know that they have a housing counselor, a legal services provider on their side to help them get through this struggle is priceless. So I thank all of you for enabling us to do that. The seeds for the partnership between my office and CXHE were planted very shortly after I was first took office as Attorney General in 2011. New York was in the depths of a foreclosure crisis that resulted from the 2008 crash of the housing market. There were 345,000 New York families facing foreclosure in January 2011, no one had been held accountable for the misconduct that caused the crisis, and so I determined to take on what was then a very tough fight to deliver relief to struggling New York families and communities that have been devastated, and to hold the financial institutions that contributed to that crash accountable. I made a commitment to say that to New York families that no one should be foreclosed on in our state because they do not have access to a lawyer or housing counselor. That is a pledge that I've made. That is a pledge I continue to fulfill. And with your help, we're providing those services to thousands and thousands of families across the state. Together, we have succeeded in helping a lot of people, but together, we're gonna help even more. And partly, I wanna mention, before I get into some of the numbers about the housing, that another critical element of this work really was the issue of accountability for the financial crisis. The billions of dollars that have gotten from banks are a tremendous resource. They've created the resources for us to help struggling families, But it's important to recognize that the fight we undertook in 2011 to ensure that there was some accountability is very, very important in and of itself. When I became the only attorney general in the country who refused to sign on to a deal that would have let the largest banks off for much, much less money than they clearly are paying now, and many more banks have yet to get to the table, I was pretty isolated, and I was a brand new attorney general. And it really was, before we even got to running the HOPP program together, it really was housing activists and community activists and housing groups across America that joined with me in saying, no, we really do need accountability. Because, you know, at that point, there was an effort underway to rewrite history. And I don't know if you'll recall this, but it was the crash happened, and there were a lot of folks acting like, well, this was like an earthquake, a perfect storm, you know, something like that. This is not an earthquake or a tsunami. This is a man-made crisis, and it was important to establish some accountability for the people who caused it, and to try as much as we can, and in New York we've succeeded to a greater degree than pretty much any other state, in making sure that whatever resources were became available as a result of that get to the communities and get to the people who were hurt by the crash. This is not, by the way, about demonizing Wall Street. I come from Wall Street. I spent most of my career in private practice. I was a partner in a big law firm representing big financial institutions and stock and commodities exchanges. But it is very important that if our capital markets are to remain the best in the world, which I think is tremendously important to the United States and to the world, we must continue to function well with the understanding that there is one set of rules that will be respected, and that there's no one that is above the law. So this is about restoring investor and public confidence in our markets. And the way we went about this in 2011 was really rather remarkable when I reflect on it. And I couldn't have done it without really all of your national counterparts who joined in the effort to sway the other AGs and sway the Obama administration to taking a more aggressive posture. We were able to negotiate a national mortgage servicing settlement that required the five largest mortgage servicing banks to reform their practices and treat homeowners more fairly. They provided also an agreement that they would write down and provide financial relief to homeowners in the amount of $25 billion as a minimum, and to help struggling homeowners across the nation, mostly principal write downs and rate reductions. And I wanted to make sure, though, that that settlement did not stop the investigation. So we made sure that the settlement, and this was one of the conditions for me signing on, allowed us to continue investigating the root causes of the crisis. So all over the United States, there were people that were hurting, and they didn't want to hear that our problems, and keep in mind, 2011, state budgets had crashed. A lot of programs were being zeroed out. And there was this rhetoric that I found particularly offensive, that our problem was not that reckless deregulation and financial chicanery had blown up the markets. Our problem was that we were paying too much in pensions to cops and teachers and firefighters. I've investigated thoroughly the cause of the crash of the housing market, and there were no cops, teachers, or firefighters anywhere near the cause of the housing bubble and crash. So we went on with this investigation after the mortgage servicing settlement. Our working group got going, and I'm proud of the fact that President Obama in January 2012, after this year of the organizing and really great collective effort to change the way our national government approaches problem, I'm proud of the fact that the President appointed me and announced in his State of the Union address in 2012 that I was going to be a co-chair of this task force to investigate the misconduct and to try and hold the banks accountable. And it was a challenging project because it involved keeping all these different federal agencies and states together, because we knew that there was a tremendous advantage, and it would be better for the banks and better for everyone if you can resolve all the claims at once and get as much money pumped back into the system as possible. In some respects, at least in New York, where we did very well, and I feel as though some of the work we're doing is what might have been done had the stimulus package been broader and more effective and gone deeper. And I think I know that we are reviving the housing market and helping people in every corner of the state. As you've probably heard, our working group has started to bring in even more money than anyone imagined. Last fall, we announced what was at the time the largest settlement with an institution in American history, $13 billion from JP Morgan Chase, with $1 billion of that coming to New York. Last month, we secured an even bigger settlement, $16.65 billion from Bank of America, including more than $800 million for New York, and we're continuing to investigate and bring other cases. Now, the key for us has been not just holding them accountable, but being smart about how we spend the money. And unfortunately, in some states, the funds were just used to close budget gaps or to fund old programs. I insisted that that was not the way we were going to handle things in New York, and we did something that no one else did, and the results have been a spectacular success. We realized that to make the most of the relief that was available to New Yorkers through federal programs for loan modification or through the bank's agreements to modify loans, we needed to fund the infrastructure. We needed you all. We needed housing counselors and legal services providers to help our homeowners navigate the process. There were people all over America who were actually eligible for loan modifications, but just didn't know it, or didn't know how to go about doing it, or missed the window. So this investment in the infrastructure has been a tremendous success, and that is our collective success that I'm happy to celebrate here today. When I took office, about half of the families facing foreclosure never had a chance to talk to a lawyer or housing counselor. We have turned that around dramatically. So the experience for all, and all of you went through it with me, or a lot of you went through it with me, when there was a crash and then there were some federal stimulus funds and then the funds dried up. So it was a good thing that as of 2012, I could start to get funds rolling in from the settlements with the banks. We managed to save a lot of programs that would be zeroed out. And it is something that has made a great difference. We funded around 90 different agencies all across the state. We initially committed $60 million for the first 2 years of the Homeowner Protection Program, this network. And we've just finished those 2 years, and there is a report that is available summarizing the tremendous successes that we've had. And many CXHE member agencies have been at the core of this, and I thank you for the great results that are reflected in our report. Now, in addition to helping more people and making sure more New Yorkers know what they're eligible for, one of the advantages of this extensive network of on-the-ground experts is that you've helped us to gather data on exactly who has been hurt by the foreclosure crisis, what factors put families at risk of foreclosure, and what practices on the part of mortgage servicers have contributed to families losing their homes even after these deals were negotiated. We found that over the last 2 years, Brooklyn, Queens, Long Island, and the Hudson Valley were disproportionately affected by the crash. In some communities, like Hempstead on Long Island and East New York and Brooklyn, roughly a quarter of the mortgages are 90 or more days delinquent. So we're able now, with the data and the feedback we're getting, to target our resources in the best ways. We found that loss of income due to unemployment or underemployment is the leading cause of borrowers becoming delinquent on loan payments. This accounts for about half of the distressed borrowers out there. Other common causes of financial distress were medical expenses, divorce, and hardships related to the massive storms that are coming about as a result of changing climate, which is a speech I'm giving later this week. We also tracked reports of mortgage servicers failing to live up to the requirements for the servicing reforms that they agreed to in these settlements. We found that the most common violations were extensive delays in responding to and processing applications for modification, asking for the same documents over and over again, and delay can be deadly for families because as the process drags on, more fees and interest accumulates, and it becomes harder to make modifications work. So my office has been able to use the data that we have gotten through the HOPP network to direct resources where they're needed most, and to develop and implement further reforms and further programs that have helped to cut down on harmful delays in the process. We were able to get passed, and a lot of you were helpful in this, the Certificate of Merit law, which essentially makes it impossible for a bank or mortgage servicer to bring a foreclosure action without filing the paperwork that triggers the borrower's right to a settlement conference. A lot of these folks were just bringing the action and they were avoiding filing the one form that would trigger these rights for the homeowner. This law serves to both expedite settlement conferences, which benefit the struggling families, and it allows us to do a better job of clearing this backlog of cases that have become a significant drain on New York's judicial system. And through this process, we've tracked and kept on top of where the worst problems are, tracked the performance of our HOPP network, and today, with issuing our second annual report, I think it makes clear that in the first 24 months of this program, which involved a significant period of time just setting it up and getting the communications moving, we've made remarkable progress. Thanks to those of you on the front lines, the HOPP program has provided close to 34,000 families with free, high-quality housing counseling and legal services. More than 11,000 New York families have loan modifications pending or approved, and people all over the state are learning that there is help available, and that the more success we have, the more people come forward and the more people will be able to help. So we've tried to make the HOPP program as accessible as possible, because one of the things we learned pretty quickly was that the worst way to try and communicate with homeowners that there was relief available was to do it in the form of a letter from the bank. A lot of these people were not interested in opening or reading a letter from the bank, and certainly not interested in coming to the bank to see if they were going to help them. So we've done some TV and radio across the state promoting this. We have set up a hotline, and as a result of your good work, more than 9,300 families have used our hotline to connect with a HOPP provider in their area. And the data also confirms that we're serving the New Yorkers who need help the most, and this is all in the report. More than half of HOPP clients earn less than $50,000 per year, and more than 5,700 single-parent households have received assistance through our HOPP network. And together, we are realizing the goal of maximizing relief for New Yorkers from the national mortgage settlement and the settlements that we've gotten from individual banks since then. When the national mortgage settlement was announced, HUD projected that New York families would get about $600 million worth of relief, rate reduction and principal reduction. But because we've invested in the infrastructure, because of all of you, in fact, when they analyzed the money that had flowed from that first settlement, New York families had gotten more than three times what HUD had projected. We've got close to $2 billion in write-downs and other assistance, and that is because of all of you. By every measure, the HOPP program has been a tremendous success. We know this from the numbers, but over the last 2 years, I've also had a chance to meet personally with some HOPP counselors and with families that were helped by HOPP counselors and lawyers. A few weeks ago, I met with counselors from the UNHS Homeownership Center in Utica, along with several different families who had recently had their homes saved by UNHS. These homeowners got loan modifications, in some cases that reduced their monthly payments by hundreds of dollars, allowed them to stay in their homes, and really that is what I'm seeing in communities all over the state as a result of the good work you're doing. I wish I could tell you that because of all of our work together, we've ended the foreclosure crisis and that we can shut down the HOPP program. Unfortunately, that's not the reality on the ground. According to the New York Federal Reserve Bank, over 225,000 mortgages in New York State were either in foreclosure or were 90 days or more delinquent as of December of 2013. So that translates into almost 1 in 10 first mortgages in our state, and that's why we are ramping up our commitment in the third year of HOPP, which is just starting right now, focusing on the communities that are most in need. And today I'm announcing that we are also committing the funding to extend the HOPP program for another 2 years. For each of the first 2 years to provide services across the state. The third year, which we're just beginning now, we've actually boosted that up to close to $25 million to increase the capacity of our network in the hardest hit communities. Again, focusing in on where the data tells us the problems are. Increased capacity in the Hudson River Valley, Brooklyn, Queens, and Long Island, among other parts of the state that we're going to be focusing on. And today, we're committing the extra $40 million so that this goes from being a three-year program to a five-year program, and we will continue to work on being as creative as we can be with all of you as our colleagues. Every time you do help some people, help a family, we see patterns emerge, we try to be responsive to that, and we've made some significant progress and changes, passed some legislation. There's more legislation that I'm going to ask you for your help passing next legislative session. But extending the HOPP program is critical because you know what it's like to have families lose their homes. It's terrible for the families, it's terrible for it as to unemployment, as to kids dropping out of school, and also creates blight, because even if you manage to save your home, if you're on a street with a bunch of abandoned properties, you're facing a different kind of problem. And we've been taking steps through our funding of land banks to address that as well. But the impact of the HOPP program has been tremendous, and we've just added a new element that I hope, look forward to all of you using and to getting more data on this new innovation in the HOPP program. That by the time we hit our third year report, there are some families that counseling alone cannot solve their problems. There's some families that just miss qualifying for a loan modification because they have a small debt or a lien, whether it's credit card debt or they missed a few payments or a medical debt. So what we're doing through a program that we now call our Mortgage Assistance Program, or MAP, is going to enable loans of up to $40,000 to be run through our HOPP network. That really becomes sort of like second mortgages. These loans enable people to pay down the debt so they qualify for a modification the bank is offering. And then these are no interest loans that do not become due until the mortgage is matured or the sale of the home takes place. They're going to be administered through the HOPP network, and we're going to keep track of every single home and make sure that each of these loans is a bridge to a family keeping their home. And so we have to continue this great interactive process where we try and hold people accountable, we do the work of law enforcement, we stand up for the principle that there's one set of rules for everyone, and then we work extra hard to see that the money goes to help the people who were hurt most by the crash and the communities who were hurt most by the crash. And the MAP program and the expansion of HOPP are going to open the door to thousands and thousands more New Yorkers for the opportunity to keep their homes, the opportunity to have their communities grow. And there are places around the state of New York that I've already seen it, and I look forward to seeing it more, where it's clear that we are raising up the whole community, where we're helping move the housing market. And there's a lot more hope in a lot of places than there was 4 years ago. And when I come and visit with you in another year, I expect it to be better still. So we've made a lot of progress. Hold the banks accountable, restore confidence for investors, sending the message that our financial markets have one set of rules. We've helped tens of thousands of New York families. People are staying in their homes. People are getting legal services and housing counseling to help them with a wide variety of personal circumstances that make it hard for people, and in other states, prevent people from actually getting the modifications that they're eligible for. You are the key to our success, and we will continue to work with you to look at the information you provide us, to analyze the data that flows in so we can do things even better, we can deliver even more effectively, and by providing high quality housing counseling and legal services, you are making this happen all over the state of New York. Collaborating with all of you and with all of our other HOPP partners, I look forward to more success in the months and years to come as we continue to be innovative, as we continue to use what we've got as New Yorkers to help other New Yorkers. Ladies and gentlemen, big programs are not coming out of Washington anytime in the near future. I know this may come as a shock to some of you, but it is, in my lifetime, it has never been as important that those of us in state and local government step up and fill the gap left by the dysfunction that's taking place in Washington. In New York, through this program, we are doing just that, and I look forward to doing it with you and working on even more creative solutions to these problems in the years ahead. Thank you very much.